What is up, everyone? How are you all doing? I hope you're all doing great, and I hope you're all staying safe. Today's video is packed with news, and while everyone else is trying out Gorn for the Oculus Quest, I am going to be informing you guys, because there's so much that has happened last night. Like, honestly, I was scrolling through the news, and there was just, like, news upon news upon news. So, if you guys want Gorn, check out some of the other great creators, and I will have them linked down below. If you want some news, stick with me. So, first thing. Another new headset. Now, this one is quite interesting. It's from Canon. Out of all companies, Canon. Now, I'm not sure if all of you know who Canon is, but Canon make cameras, like video cameras, like the one you're on right now, and they've made a VR and AR headset. How confusing is that? Looking straight at this headset, it looks like nothing we have ever seen before. It kind of just looks like a slab that you kind of put in front of your face. I don't know how light leakage would work here, but honestly, this is one of the most innovative designs we have seen in the VR space so far. Every other headset kind of follows the same design pattern. This is like a whole different thing, and I don't know how I feel about it. Honestly, I can see how this thing can be used as a pair of binoculars, but that's kind of weird. Also, it has like an LED light in the front, you know, to tell you when it's on. Looks pretty cool, pretty damn futuristic. Even my dog's damn happy about it. So, first of all, weight, because weight is important when you're wearing something on your face the entire time. In this video, we learned that the headset weighs an impressive 137 grams. That's pretty impressive, and claims to have the smallest, thinnest, and lightest of Canon's offerings, with a head strap attached, and it can be flipped in an upward position and adjusted for a fit. A mechanical IPD adjuster, yes, is also built into the headset's lenses. As previously seen, the Emreal S1 can also be used like a pair of handheld binoculars, which is quite weird. We haven't seen that aspect of VR before. I mean, I guess you could if you took off the head strap off of any one of these, but that's kind of funny. Now, this part's really cool. It seems to have hand tracking built in. So, all in all, it seems like a pretty damn good headset. The question is, will it be available for consumers? And for what price? Let me know what you guys think down below. Now, you guys know I love haptics. You guys know I love anything that increases the immersion in virtual reality, and gloves are part of that. We need those quality gloves that will give us haptics and allow us to grab something and like squeeze it, but only squeeze it to a certain point. Well, I'm happy to say Haptex Gloves DK2 just got a big upgrade, but the price is still a secret. Reading from Upload VR, we can see that the Haptex Glove have true contact haptics, basically meaning 133 tactile feedback points per hand that physically push against your skin to simulate the textures of objects. That is absolutely insane. Imagine holding like, I don't know, what's a pretty textured object? Cactus. Yeah, let's just hold a cactus in our hand. And imagine being able to feel those prongs? Spikes on the cactus. That is pretty damn amazing. Now, of course, I can only imagine it won't be that sharp. Like, that would be pretty concerning, but that is incredible. Like, we've had the gloves that kind of pull your fingers back. These actually make you feel stuff. 133 points to allow you to feel haptics and get feedback in VR. Absolutely incredible and so, so exciting that the technology is going ahead. Now, how much do you want to bet that this thing will cost more than like 2,000 euro? Which means it'll be out of the reach for consumers, but as it says here, Haptex gloves are already used in military training, Nissan designers, and surgical training. So, you can kind of tell that this thing is more aimed at companies, but still pretty damn cool and exciting. The more of this tech we see, the closer it comes to consumers. Now onto more games. As we all know, Gorn releases today, but another game has just been teased. I Expect You to Die 2 will be coming out this year. When exactly, we don't know, but we just got the teaser for it. And let me tell you, it looks just as good as the first one. If you guys didn't play the first one, I Expect You to Die is a puzzle-solving game where you are a secret agent and the narrator expects you to die. But of course, you're supposed to not die, you know, kind of like you do in the real world. But this looks pretty damn cool. I'm excited for it, can't wait to see it, and can't wait to see what the gameplay consists of. Let me know what you think down below. So, Google's Tilt Brush has been discontinued, unfortunately. If you guys were really into the game, you'll know. However, they didn't just go and shut down the app like other companies would, which I personally really love. Well, the not shutting it down part, not the app companies that do shut them down. They've gone open source, and open source is my favorite type of source, because that means we, the community, get access to the source code, meaning that people can keep the project alive without Google completely just getting rid of it, which is very exciting, because usually when projects do go open source, the community thinks of some incredible ways to improve upon them that maybe the company didn't know about, or just didn't think of. And this is great. Tiltbrush was one of the first apps I actually played in VR. I was amazed at how incredible it is to draw in the 3D virtual space, and honestly, this is great. This is amazing. Thanks, Google, for not discontinuing the project that I love. Now, Facebook's Andrew Bosworth decided to talk a little bit about the Apple VR headset, and he had a few things to say. And I just personally think this is pretty interesting, so I will actually tell you guys about it. He did an AMA on Instagram. He does quite a few of those AMAs, and I'm reading from Upload VR right now. In his latest Instagram AMA, one user asked Bosworth what his thoughts were on the Apple VR standalone headset. Here is his full response. Not really. I don't mean to be glib about it. I'd love to have more people putting more VR headsets out there. It's good for consumers. I'm a little skeptical if that's really what Apple is going to do, given I don't know where their content is going to come from, but you know, they're great, so I hope they do. Now, I've kind of put my thoughts out there about the fact that I don't think this thing is going to support Steam VR, so I'm with him on that one. But where their content is going to come from? I don't know. Pretty interesting. And it's quite interesting to see him on an Instagram AMA talking about it. Now, the Oculus Quest unlisted app distribution. Now, the launch was supposed to happen last week, but unfortunately, it didn't. This is pretty exciting because it means we'll be able to download apps apart from the Oculus Store, which is very good because, again, not all apps are on the Oculus Store. But with this unlisted app distribution, it would be much easier to download apps that just aren't official. And that is good for us as consumers. So this is pretty exciting. Another super exciting thing to be excited about if you guys have that Oculus Quest and want to be going into this. And finally, the Oculus Quest is being very, very successful. And I feel like that is important to mention here because a lot of you either just joined the VR space or a lot of you joined the VR space over Christmas. So you are part of these numbers and you are helping virtual reality rise. And the Oculus Quest 2 more than doubled Facebook's Q4 non-ads revenue from last year, which is absolutely insane because that's a huge number. And if we get double the amount of people in VR this year, well, 2020 than we did 2019, wow, my numbers, that's amazing. The VR space is growing, and the more people are into a certain topic, the more companies will get interested. That is that. A lot of really exciting news. Gorn, I will be downloading whenever I can pay for it. If you got this far, we're going on to Reddit. But again, the Reddit has a little bit of a different format. You guys vote. I do. Top 4 most upvoted Reddit comments. So let's go. Reddit, where are you at? See guys, I'd open the window, but there's like children screaming outside. So if I do that, like it's getting really hot in here. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna open the window, but you guys are just gonna hear random screaming, so. So yeah, this is a thing. This isn't actually the top most upvoted one, but this is something that Axe sent me today morning. It is something that I'm very concerned about, but I'll cut you guys a deal. There's very little room in this room, and that is a problem. However, this post states, petition for Mystical to get a huge cardboard cutout of Axeril and put it in the back of his room. Yeah, this is very concerning. However, I'll cut you guys a deal. These things aren't cheap. I googled this just for the meme. If this gets 200 votes for yes, I'll do it. We have 365 members on the Reddit, so I think that is a perfectly reasonable amount. If this gets that amount, I'll do it, okay? And now, let's move into the top upvoted in the past 24 hours. Let's go. As monies, the Mystical after inventing virtual reality business. Absolutely. Yes, this is exactly what I look like when I invent virtual reality, which I do, you know, guys, just every Saturday, pretty much. Okay, this is great. This is just some quality Photoshop. It's official. The Mystical is a vampire. And it's just a pic of me with my Oculus Quest and the umbrella, which I went outside with yesterday while it was raining. Of course someone was gonna meme it, but they put it on a beach. You guys, I don't think I'm a vampire. I don't know, though. Like, honestly, like, God damn it, guys. Good job. Good job. Quality meme. Thank you so much for posting. Greatly appreciated. Then we have when I tell Mystical not to go out in the rain, and then I do it anyway. Can't stop me from making content. And then what I see and what the family sees. Yes, this is actually quite accurate. It's also quite concerning. Like, it makes you think a lot, you know? Like, when you're in VR, like, you look so stupid, you know? So guys, that's that. I hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, please give it a like. If you guys disliked it, I guess this button works too, but please tell me why down in the comment section below. We got a lot covered today, so I'm pretty happy with that. If you guys are not yet part of the community and would like to join, make sure to join down below. We have a Discord down there, we have a Reddit down there, obviously. So make sure to join that and start posting those spicy memes, voting on those votes. And if you guys want to support the channel in any way, shape, or form, we've got sick merch down below, mysticalstore.com, sick mugs, sick jackets that don't put a huge ad on your body. And if you guys want to be notified by future content coming up on the channel daily, make sure to smack that subscribe button with your forehead, ding my bell, and see you again in the next video. Peace.